Greetings, let's introduce ourselves into INI and ITU. So, INI means this in Indonesian, and ITU is that, okay? This and that. Now, how do you use this in sentences? Well, we can use this in sample cases. Let me give a few examples. So, for example, apa INI? And that can be a question, right? Apa is what? INI is this. So this sentence means what is this? You just say what this, and that's how you say what is this. Okay, so apa ini? And now, for example, you can say ini rumah saya. This means this is my house. Okay. So ini is this, rumah house, and saya is I, but if you put it after it, it means that it's your house, okay? So this is the kind of idea. Now, we see how ini plays out in sentences. You can also say, for example, I don't know, saya sangat suka ini, which means I really like this. Why? I really like this. Just the way it is. Ini can be used as a subject, object, and so on. Questions, answers, and all that kind of stuff. Now, itu doesn't mean this, but it means that. So, for example, siapa orang itu? Now, we see this is not the subject or object. It's not by itself, but it qualifies orang, which means person. Siapa is who? So, who, person, that. And as it's after it, it means that person. So we have orang itu, that person. Now, this is placed after the orang because it's that person, and you don't say itu orang because that would already mean something else. Itu orang, because we don't use the word be, it just means that is a person. So itu orang is that and person, but it's not like that person. You would have to put itu after it for it to be pointing at the person, but when you just place, this is the subject and this is the object, so this is already a sentence where you're saying that is a person without the word be in between there. So that's the reason why it's like that. So that's the big difference between orang itu and itu orang. So we have to understand the itu and itu still, itu, but in different cases it might play out differently in the sentence. So we can both say, for example, orang, as I show here, okay? Orang ini, orang itu. So this means person, this means this. So this means this person. You put the this after the word. So keep that in mind. And orang itu, just like with any other adjective in Indonesian, you put it after the word. So orang itu, that means that person. Now, this is qualifying some other word, but we can also use it by itself as I showed. So for example, ini kota Jakarta. Ini kota Jakarta. This is the city Jakarta. Okay. So why? Because this is as a subject, and we don't need the word be in this case at all. We can just use ini kota and Jakarta, where ini is this. This is kota, that means city, and Jakarta is Jakarta. So just put the information where first is the subject, then you have the object, which kota Jakarta is just city Jakarta. Literal translation, nothing more complicated than that. Or you can say itu kota Jakarta, and that means that is city Jakarta, where this is this and this is that. And you see that city Jakarta, and it means that is city Jakarta, but we don't have any is here, we don't have any connection with the word, using the word be in here. It's just without that, okay? You don't use such stuff really in Indonesian.